it's almost like time stopped. There were still things, background TVs playing, lights blinking, drinks that had just been poured, checks are about to be paid, food half eaten. And that's not even thinking about the bodies on the ground. But when you actually see everyone lying down in one place, or everyone down in one place, or their final positions, you can feel it.
In addition to police, fire, EMS, there's always another team that responds to tragedies, the medical examiners, like Dr. Joshua Stephany. He is speaking about this for the first time.
When I heard the number 11 or 12 people deceased at the hospital from one shooting, I said, that's a lot, but our normal staff can handle it. Then as the morning went on, I started getting more texts, more calls. Then I realized the scope of the disaster, or the event, that numbers were starting to come in, 20 at the nightclub, 30 at the nightclub.
For all of the victims, figure out cause and manner of death. That's his job. Surprisingly, the answers aren't always obvious.
So law enforcement can recreate what happened. So we need to get the projectiles. We need to tell them the injury pattern, entrances, exits, what they hit.
You can't say for sure, full metal jacket, hollow tip, all from one.
Not from the fragments I recovered now.
Dr. Stephany is still piecing together the fragments from this tragedy, but he made a point to tell me no one died from trampling or other causes.
No secret that all the causes are going to be the same. I mean, we all know what happened there.
By Monday, he wanted all the victims identified.
A lot of people had identification on them. So we'll take that ID and look at it, compare it, and if we can make a positive ID off that, we'll use that. If we need other information, if the weight of the person's cleaned up a little bit and recompare, that's one thing. We can do what's called quick prints. We can take a thumbprint hooked up to a laptop computer, run their print and see what their photos come up as and see if that can compare. We can get that family information, personal effects, tattoos.
By Tuesday, he wanted all the autopsies completed.
I wanted to complete our process as soon as we could and as efficient as we could so we could get those victims back with their loved ones. I think that was very important to myself and the rest of my staff. We're a public office. We serve the public. And that is, a public mission to reunite those people with their families.
Another sign of respect that you won't find in any rule book.
It was important for you to separate the shooter from the other victims.
Myself and my staff, we just felt it was only right. There was no legal reason for it, no normal protocol for it. We just felt in our minds it was probably best, ethically maybe, morally, to keep them separate. So the shooter was transported by himself. He was kept in that other building by himself. I autopsied him by myself alone in that building, away from the victims, out of respect for the victims and their families.
As of tonight, no one has claimed the shooter's body.
You mentioned earlier that families can call you, they can talk to you, you make yourself available to them. I'm just wondering, what do you say to them?
And the most common question is, did my loved one suffer? And honestly, 99 out of 100 times, that is the question they ask. In cases such as this, I will tell them, I don't think they suffered one bit. I didn't see any evidence of movement or trying to struggle. It, like I said, in the beginning, when I got in there in the scene, it's almost like everyone just stopped and laid down where they were.
Dr. Sanjay Gupta, CNN, Orlando.